my friends. Welcome to Fun Fact Friday with Kenzie King. How's everybody doing? Oh, would you look at that. My daughter colored her face today with magic markers and fell asleep on my shirt. So now my face is colored. My shirt is colored. That's okay. Hi, Jeff. Okay, so Fun Fact Friday. Did you know there's this thing called geocaching? There is. So if you have a device that you can get coordinates on, like, you know, GPS coordinates, you can go onto this website, geocaching.com. You can create an account. It's free. And you can get these coordinates to different sites all around the world. So it's people like you and me who do this site that can go, and people will put in, like, Tupperware containers, any type of container that is waterproof. Like ammunition canisters, people have used those. But they'll put little like trinkets in there. So maybe like a goofy eraser, or maybe a coin from a foreign country, just anything. It can be anything whatsoever. I just saw one today that had a frequent user punch card for a donut store. So you put anything you want in there with a little notebook, and well, the person who creates this box puts the notebook in there, because when you actually find it based on the coordinates that you get online, you can take or put things back into this geocache box. And then you write on the little notebook, you know, Kenzie was here on, you know, the 28th of June. I left a eraser and I took that $1,000 bill that was inside. So you exchange. You don't have to take things. You don't have to leave things. But that's kind of the fun of it, to keep the process going. Hi, Dallas. So I did this for a little while and I thought it was the funnest thing, because I think treasure hunts are really fun. I think I could have been a treasure hunting pirate. I think I would have enjoyed that. And so these are really fun. And you can go, you know, you can decide on the difficulty level that you want to approach. Each time somebody creates one, they put, you know, how hard it was, if it was a difficult hike to get to the place, if it's right off the side of the road, there's like little hints and stuff. So you can decide if you want to attempt it. But the one we found today was right off the side of the road. My daughter loves to find it because she knows exactly where it is. She tells me which way to go and which rock to move to unbury this canister. And it is fun. So if this is something that, you know, kind of sounds like it might be up your alley, go check it out, geocaching.com. And then you can, you know, track how many caches you find. And when we went to Hawaii, oh, thank you, Tristan. Hi, Tony. When we went to Hawaii once, we went there on standby tickets. And the day we landed, two airlines went out of business. So, you could probably guess what happened to our vacation. It got extended! Yes! My dad was a little scared and upset because he had to get to work, but I was, you know, I worked from home, so I was like, this is awesome. I wasn't worried. I didn't want to hurry up and get home. So we were actually in Hawaii for 9 extra days before we were able to get a flight out. I loved it. I thought it was great. But during that time, we had taken some geocaching coordinates already. And so we went and found those. And then we found some more online because I had my laptop. We were able to find more. And it was fun because it really took us places that we wouldn't have normally gone. And we had 9 days. So why not? We explored all over the island and we saw a lot of fun things. So if that sounds like something fun for you, go give it a try. It's great. Get out there. Go see the world. Go see things you might not think to see otherwise. And, you know, it works your brain, because some of them, they're riddles you have to solve to get the clue. And that was always really fun. So the other day, this is an off topic, and I just thought of it because I've got some wheels over there on the floor. The other day, I had my office chair on my trailer. I was moving stuff around. So I had my office chair on the trailer, you know, trucking along. I look in the rear view and it's like Wizard of Oz office chair flying through the air. And I'm like, no, you know, those slow motion things where you know what the outcome's going to be. No. And that chair hit the ground and like the wheels exploded off of the chair. And thankfully, I was so glad that nobody was behind me. I was on a very rural road.